They never believed in me, and this is coming from singer Medi as he reveals his issues with P-Square, or should I say the Okoye brothers. He said Jude Okoye suddenly gave him a contract to sign, and it was just around the time the Okoye brothers lost their mother. He told Jude to hold on as regards the contract till after their mom's burial, but he refused, insisting it'd be given attention at the time. He also mentioned that he was promised not to be given any contract and that he could use their platform to push his career. In the same vein, he also said they did not give him a contract because they did not believe in him. So, yeah.
Anyone would be glad about such an arrangement that, oh, where you make your money, you can run off with our platform and do all of that. You know, I'd be like, well, this nice guy. He even said in the video that I love these guys. Do you understand? Like, anyone would want to run with that, but suddenly, you did Chop My Money remix, and Akon was also featured on that, and people were talking about Medi, because I can remember that period where like, Medi killed it, Medi and Akon's verse were dope, you understand? So people were paying more attention to the people who were featured on the remix at that time. And then I can imagine how many shows they had gone for, and he had to split their money with them. And obviously, a Jude Okoye, if you think about it, would be like, wow, that's a lot of money. This is a time for us to push out a contract and see how we can get this. But saying they didn't believe in him, I don't know. I wasn't there. But if that's what he's saying, obviously he must have seen a couple of things for him to say that these guys did not believe in him. So let's just believe what Medi has said. And if that's the case, I think we need to do better in terms of signing. So even before you jump on a feature, what's the future? That's what
you're rapping now. Before you jump on a feature, what's the future? But if I don't agree with you, like, you coming out to say they did not believe in you, I think it's a stretch. Because if they did not believe in you, why would they even give you their platform? Maybe they underestimated you, maybe, but not believing in you and having you on Chop My Money Remix, not believing in you, just another song again they had him on. I can't remember the title right now. And you're saying they did not believe in you. So what were you doing on the track? You were supposed to be holding mic, or I don't know, how did you get on those track? I'm not comfortable with him using those particular words, one. And secondly, why is he talking now? Is it because he has an album that I haven't been able to find on Apple Store to listen to?
No, I think he was probably on a live with somebody.
Yeah. Is this the first time he has the opportunity on going on live? Why is it now that he's talking? Clearly, there's something he's promoting. But all I want to say to him is that what that thing he's promoting is also not even reachable for people who may want to listen to him right now. So he needs to go back to actually check his strategy, and maybe he's still towing the same line that made him leave the business in the first place. Because I don't understand the idea.
Why? He left the business.
Didn't he? Was he still in business? I don't know. I wasn't seeing a lot of Medi. And even now that he has an album, I think I saw it because, was it Bizzo that tweeted about it or something? And then I went to his page and I saw that, okay, there's an album.
Do you remember that verse on Chop My Money?
For when I think of Medi, I just remember soundtrack. I love soundtrack. Yeah, I love soundtrack. I cannot
soundtrack
pretend.
Can never get old.
It can like, never get old. I've listened to it over and over this morning, and that was an amazing job. And then
there
was
see the love I get for you, not Jackie Chan.
Pusha!
Yeah. Somersault for you, you know I can.
But if my point is, there are other ways for him to blow. He needs to sit down and understand the music business, speak to the right people. If he doesn't have money, look for investors and push his music out there. I wouldn't say I don't believe in him, because he has given us some good vibes, right? He has his kind. There was one I listened to this morning that didn't make sense anyway, but I can't remember the title, so let me think of it myself. But he has a kind of vibe for himself, and I think he can work on that, not trying to drag the Okoye brothers into his popularity game.
I don't think it's dragging, because a lot of people questioned at that time that why was he not signed, because it was a belief that he has been signed, right? A lot of people believe that they had signed Medi into the record label. All of a sudden, we stopped.
But he was the one who didn't want to be signed at the end of the day. Because he was saying that, yeah, you said use your platform and go. So is it wrong for a business owner to decide to change his mind?
Especially when they see that you're a right prospect. So I don't think this conversation is inconclusive, if you ask me, because I want to know. So when they gave you the contract, was it that the deal wasn't favorable? Was it that the money was too small?
Yeah.
Was it that they were trying to rip you off? You didn't give us details.
Yeah, which is why I'm not comfortable
that.
With just watching
so
this
I think
video
this
and making
video
an opinion.
Is so inconclusive. So it needs to come out and tell us more, unless he said it and we didn't see it.